Hi, welcome to the first tutorial on deep learning and neuroscience. First, a little bit about me. I'm Carson Stringer, and I'm a group leader at HHMI Genelia Research Campus. I'm trying to figure out how neurons perform complex high-dimensional computations such as object recognition and object segmentation. To answer this question, I've worked on a number of software packages to process and visualize neural activity. One package I've developed called CellPose uses a deep neural network to perform cellular segmentation. Using deep networks to process images will be talked about more in the outro by Ms. Michelle Johnson. First, I'd like to thank our tutorial creator, Jorge A. Menendez, and all the tutorial reviewers we had, and I'll allow Jorge to introduce himself.
Hello, my name is Jorge. I'm a PhD student at the Gatsby Computational Neuroscience Unit at University College London, where I study recurrent neural networks and motor control in the brain. I really believe that a lot of the tools and concepts from deep learning can be extremely useful for understanding and thinking about information processing in the brain, so I hope some of these ideas come through in the tutorials that you'll be doing and you get something out of them. Enjoy!
Thanks, Jorge. All right, so during this course, you've been introduced to decoding and encoding models. Decoding models, such as the one you developed in week one, day four, are used to predict external correlates from neural activity. In this case, you predicted the choice of a mouse in a decision-making task using neural activity from various brain areas. By doing this, you can determine how much information a brain area has about a given external correlate. Encoding models, on the other hand, are used to predict neural activity from external correlates. You built a model such as this on week one, day four, to predict retinal neural activity from image pixels. This type of model can help you understand how a brain area represents different external correlates, such as visual stimuli. In both of these cases, you use the linear models. Today, we will use deep neural networks to build decoding and encoding models due to their ability to fit nonlinear functions and their ability to be fit easily. So in these tutorials, we will be exploring neural activity in mice while the mice are viewing oriented grating stimuli on a screen in front of it. We record this neural activity using a technique called two-photon calcium imaging, which allows us to record many thousands of neurons simultaneously. These neurons light up when they fire. We then convert this imaging data to a matrix of neural responses by stimuli presented. For the purpose of this tutorial, we are going to bin the neural responses and compute the neuron's tuning curve. We used bins of 1 degree. So here's what the tuning curves look like for three example neurons. We'll use the response of all neurons in a single bin in order to predict which stimulus was shown. So we're going to be using the responses of 24,000 neurons to try to predict 360 possible stimulus conditions corresponding to each of the degrees of these different orientations. So to do this, we're going to build a deep neural network to predict stimuli from neural responses because we're now in a regime of having large amounts of data. So first, let's start with a linear network with no hidden layers, where the stimulus prediction Y is a product of the weights W out and neural responses R, plus a bias term. When you fit a linear model such as this, you likely minimize the squared error between the stimulus prediction and the true stimulus. This is called the loss function. The solution to minimizing this loss function in a linear model can be found in closed form, and you learned how to solve this type of linear regression problem in the first week, if you remember. So if we use a simple linear model such as this, we are able to predict the stimulus within 2 to 3 degrees. So let's see if we can improve this prediction by using a deep neural network. So let's start by adding can we predict better using a deep neural network? So let's start by adding a single hidden layer with m units to this linear model, where now the output y depends on the activity of these hidden units h, and the hidden layer h, its activations depend on the neural responses r. This linear network with one hidden layer where m is less than n, which where n is the number of neurons, is equivalent to performing reduced rank regression, which is a technique that is actually useful for regularizing your regression model. But back to thinking about deep neural networks and their terminology. So adding this hidden layer means that the network now has a depth of 1 and a width of m. Increasing the depth and the width of this network can increase the expressivity of the model. In other words, how well it can fit complex nonlinear functions. Many state-of-the-art models now have close to 100 layers. But for now, let's start with adding this single hidden layer, so working with a model with a depth of 1, and see if we can improve our prediction of the stimulus. So to build this model, we are going to use pytorch. So first we import the pytorch module using this import torch, and then we import the neural network module, which is called NN. And now we're going to create a class for this deep network called DeepNet. And a class in Python has different functions, which are methods. And each of these methods, the first argument to these methods is self, which is a class itself. And a class in Python is initialized with this init method here, which in this case takes two inputs, n inputs and n hidden. In our case, n inputs is the number of neurons, and then n hidden is the number of hidden units that we choose to use in our model. So we first call this super function in order to invoke the NN module, which we're inheriting here, its init method. And then we add our first hidden layer, which is going to be this in layer here with an NN linear unit, which is N inputs by N hidden. And then we're only adding one hidden layer here. So now let's add the output layer, which is going to be NN linear, which is going to be N hidden by 1, because we're only predicting one stimulus here, which is the orientation here. And now we're going to add another method to this class called the forward method. And this is the method that runs when you call this class as a function. It takes as input R, which are our neural responses here, and they're passed through this first hidden layer to produce our weights, our activations H. And then they're passed through this output layer to produce our final prediction of the stimulus Y. And now that we've declared our class, let's create an instantiation of this class called net. And we're going to give it the number of inputs we have, which is the number of neurons, and then also the number of hidden units, which is 200. Now let's run our neural responses through this deep through this net. So we're going to take our neural response to a single stimulus, iStim of 0 in this case, and we're going to run the network, run the response through the network using this call of net as a function here. And this call calls the forward pass. So every deep network that you build with PyTorch, you need to make sure you have this init method and this forward method. And then you can use it in this way in order to run your data through the network.